Hey. Hi guys. Welcome back. So I have something a little different for you guys today. I know I've been popping a lot with the makeup and with health related stuff, so I wanted to bring you something more hair related. So what I am talking about is the Citra & Co. Automatic Hair Trimmer for split ends. So the company's name is Citra & Co, but they're overseas. The package took me like almost 2 months to get. So I saw this trimmer on Facebook through like one of those ads when you're running through like your feed, and I saw the video and it looked legit. So I was like, all right, whether or not it works, it might be worth a shot. So the subtotal was $50.96, and the shipping was $3.99. So my total came to $54.95. My hair story is that I have rarely found a salon that knows how to work appropriately with curly hair. So I am situated in New Jersey. I know I could easily go to Weedad or to, like any of those curly hair, like Diva Curl in New York City. But, like on a teacher's salary and makeup artist, like freelancing, $300-$400 on a haircut. Ain't nobody got money for that. So thanks to YouTube and thanks to other women who have forged the trail before me, I have learned how to cut my own hair. I know a lot of you right now are going, but honestly, like I have never had an issue cutting my own hair. All I do is trim it down and I cut a few layers into it so that I get some extra fluff. So long story short, we're gonna give this a shot today. This trimmer comes with a crap ton of accessories. So it comes with a nice carrying couch that has a pouch, and you place the trimmer in here. It has little like whatchamacallit, stretchy straps so that you can easily slip it in there. That's what he said. I always end up doing that, guys. I'm sorry. It comes with two hair clips, a massive comb for separating and combing out your hair. It comes also with a baby brush so that you can clean the clippings out. And lastly, let me just pull this out of the trimmer. It comes with two trimming attachments that look like this. So the trimmer will not work unless you have one of these attachments placed inside of it, and it is a guide that lets you know how much you want to cut off. So you have a quarter inch option and an eighth of an inch option. So because I have some massive split ends going on, I'm just going to slip the attachment for a quarter of an inch into the trimmer as so. So the trimmer charges with a USB cable, which is in my room right now, but it has two directions. So depending upon whether you are holding it this way to go down one side or flipping it the other way, you want to make sure that the corresponding direction is engaged on the machine. On the back, you have basically what is like a lever. Right now it's on the lock position because I didn't want it opened. So when you click it to lock off, it will open for you and you can insert your hair. You're gonna see there are bristles on here as well. So you place your hair in here, close this, and then run it straight down your hair, and the trimmings will end up falling into this little encasement. Now, I haven't really tried this before. I did read through the instruction manual. I wanted to experiment a little bit, and I'm not sure I should be experimenting with a tool that I have not tried before, but I'm gonna do it for ya. Okay, so I have my faithful Numi flat iron. So we're gonna try out the hair trimmer. It does recommend for you to straighten out your hair first so that way nothing gets caught within the blades. So I want to test it on one side with my hair straight. So I'm just gonna pick a couple strands that I think are the most damaged at the end. So I will be right back. I am going to flat iron a couple pieces of hair. I'm gonna leave probably this side. I'm probably gonna flat iron this side actually because I'm seeing more damage here and I'd like to see it the way it works appropriately. And I will leave this side curly so we can do a little bit of both. All right, be right back. All right, guys, I am back. I have flat ironed a couple sections of hair on this side. I'm leaving the same corresponding strands of hair. You'll see there is a whole lot of damage going on here at my ends. The first thing that you're gonna do is turn the device around. We're just gonna disengage the lock so that the trimmer falls open. And this is gonna be what we're going to close. As if you can hear, there's like a little bit of resistance there, which leads me to believe it is not the highest quality craftsmanship, but we're gonna try this anyway. So it says to use a quarter of an inch strand. So I'm gonna work in the beginning here first. So I'm going to turn it on. I'm gonna be holding it this way. So I'm just gonna press the down button there. So when I close it, you're gonna hear that the blades do begin functioning. Guys, say a little prayer now to whatever God you believe in, whatever energy you believe in, that this doesn't chop off my hair. All right. It's a little cumbersome because like it's such a big unit. So let's hope for the best. The good news is that my hair is still here. It did cut off, I mean, a fair amount of split ends. This will focus in. I think you're starting to see there's some clippings right here on the bottom. So I'm gonna start from the bottom again and just pass on it a few more times to see if it can cut a little more. Pulled out one of my hairs. Okay. I mean, it still looks dry, to be honest with you, but it feels, let's see. Is there any difference? Yeah, there's definitely a difference. This looks way more straw-like. This looks a whole lot better on the ends. But let's try this other side, the curly side. What I'm going to do is just take a comb and comb through my ends, because if I don't have to straighten my hair to get the same exact effects, then I'm not going to waste 45 minutes and dry out my hair further just to get the same results. So here's what my ends look like when they've been brushed out. You know what? What I'm going to do is empty out this casing, but here's the inside. Removed the majority of the clippings from here. It's not completely clean, but we'll be able to get the gist as to whether or not it's working. Let's try another section. And I'm still getting a whole bunch of hair pulled out. There's like 4 or 5 strands right there. The shake will make me go bald. There's definitely some clippings in there. Is it as much as on the straightened side? No, way less. So there is a reason why they say straighten your hair first. It worked way better on the straight hair side than it did on the curly side. So if you are so inclined to buy this after watching me torture myself and rip my own hair out, I'll leave the link for you down below. So consensus, let's do some pros and cons, because I like to be fair when it comes to products. So does it work? Yeah, it trims some of your hair. Is it a miracle product? No. Does it hurt when you use it inappropriately? Yes. Does it hurt on the side where the hair was already straight? A little bit. Your hair gets caught in it. Strands are gonna get pulled out. So long story short, I think just save your money, because honestly, It's just easier to buy a pair of professional shears, and even if you go section by section and just literally clip off the dead ends, you'll probably get a better result than this little doodad. So, I hate negative reviews. It makes me feel so bad because I always have like the best intentions for every product, but this one I'm gonna have to say pass because it's not worth it. It takes too long to get here. It's too much money. It hurts when you use it in your hair. It's too much of a lengthy process. You know, if you had a pair of cutting shears, you could have literally just gone through with your hair at whatever texture it is and cut right through it. And all right, guys, so the last thing that I'm gonna do is ask for your suggestions. So if you have curly hair like I do, shout out a few places. Who do you like to cut your hair? What salon do you usually go to? I'd love to know what is your best method for cutting your hair. Okay, guys, so I will stop blabbing and just ask you for two little favors. Please smash that like button and make sure you hit subscribe if you have not already, so you can join the no filter family because we ain't got no filter around here, okay? Okay. All right, guys. Have a great day. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.